Speaker number two, he is a mechanical student. His hobbies include reading and watching movies. He loves traveling. Topic today is, I feel helpless. Can we have Ankit on stage, please?
She's trapped in the prison wall. That used to be her mind. The woman that she used to be has long been left behind. Fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests, good evening.
Good evening.
Just like every day, Ma called to wake me up this morning. In no mood to get up, I still answer the phone. Good morning, beta. Good girl. She asked ever so lovingly. I replied casually. This was routine. Her calling me at least twice a day to keep a check on me. And me replying nonchalantly. Her general questions would include, how was your day? What did you eat? How are your friends? How's studies going on? And did you talk to any girl? No, she does not motivate me to talk to any girl. She's afraid that I may fall in love with a girl of some other caste. My questions are restricted only to, how are you, Ma? That one question is enough for her to tell me about everything under the sun. Mothers, you know. She continues to tell me about annoying friends and more annoying relatives, which she forgets that she had told me a day before. I listen to her, sometimes patiently, and sometimes not so patiently. Okay now, I would be lying if I say that I do not get annoyed at her. I do get annoyed at her, but sometimes a conversation puts me into a thinking mode. She is clearly getting old because she's forgetting. She's getting old and it makes me feel terrible. I remember the days when I sat on her lap and asked her meaningless questions for about 1,000 times, and each time she replied patiently. And I still remember the night before the day I left for Bangalore. She was crying. I sat beside her as she cried, but what she said next moved me. She said, "Beta, the day you see I'm getting old, I ask you to please be patient. And most of all, please understand what I'm going through. If when we talk, I forget things for 1,000 times, please do not interrupt me by saying that you've just said that thing a minute before. Just listen to me. When I get old and cannot move so quickly as earlier, please don't get angry. Just be with me." With a smile and a huge love that I've always had for you, I just want to say, I love you, Peter. And I cried for the whole night. We all talk about growing up, becoming an adult, feeling old when we are 25, pursuing things before we turn 40. But in this crazy hullabaloo, we forget that someone else is aging too. As we grow up, our parents are growing up too. Time is running, and I feel helpless. I want to be with them when they need me the most. I want to be beside them when they excitedly create a social media account for the first time, just like they were with me on my first day at school. I want to learn recipes and feed them, just like the family with my favorite delicacies when I was younger. I want to touch the wrinkles on the face and tell them how much I love them. I want to provide for them just like they provided for me every day. Sure, age is just a number. But what about death? It is more than just a word. I want to spend as much time as I can with my parents before I regret being pulled away by the busy life. Until then, until I can do anything about it, I feel happy for the same routine, you know. Mark calls me every day to wake me up. And in no mood to get up, I reply the phone. Good morning, beta. Ud gaya kya? Over to you, Toastmaster.